There's been a lot of talk around Stefano Sensi. And Nicky, I know that he's become kind of, you know, your star man. Maybe you replaced Papu Gomez in your heart.
Well, that's probably never going to happen.
But I don't know. What are the things that perhaps our listeners don't know about him?
Yeah, I thought it would be interesting to talk about him a little bit, just because he's 24 years old. He's not a kid. And he's showed up at Inter and he's having this sort of breakout season. We're all talking about him as someone potentially who we think should be a fixture for the national team as well already. And I guess the bits people might not know about his backstory, he was from Urbino, which is, I guess if you want to think of Italy as a boot, high up the calf of the boot. And he made his sort of professional start with San Marino, which is the club of the city-state. Had sort of a not sort of as quick as someone like Barella, who's playing alongside in that midfield, not as quick a rise. He went from there to Cesena, who's actually always his parent club, and then he went on to Sassuolo, and he talked about that first season at Sassuolo as being a real challenge. What's interesting is when he first got to Sassuolo, and at this point you're talking about a player who's 21 years old, so again, you can compare and contrast directly with someone like Barella, who's already doing it at that age. He said the step up from Serie B to Serie A was a big problem for him. He also talked about going off the rails a little bit, basically. He was like, you know, I got further than I was ready for at that age, and I was getting distracted by the wrong things. And
the crazy nightlife in
Sassuolo. Yeah, in Sassuolo, of all places. It's not such a big trip from Sassuolo to bigger cities, but yes. And basically, yes, you know, his family and his girlfriend, who has a tattoo for, brought him back on track a little bit. I think the other really interesting sort of element from this chapter of his life, though, actually the Cesena chapter, is he talked about working with a coach in the Cesena youth team, Fernando de, I don't know if his surname would be more Ahila, because he's from Catalonia, but a youth team coach who was then with Cesena, now is in, I believe, Orlando City in the States. And basically, at a time when lots of other coaches were looking at Sensi and going, you're too short, because he's 5'6". He's, you know, he is noticeably the smallest man on the pitch most of the time when he's playing. At a time when other coaches were saying, basically, you're not going to make it, this guy said, no, you absolutely have this, something that other people don't have. You can do this sort of quick passing, and this is, you know, using Sensi's own words, the tiki-taka, the stuff that we get this idea from Barcelona and Catalonian football culture. And essentially, like, this one figure seems to have been really important in him becoming the player that he is now. He always was a Barcelona fan, Sensi. He says he was obsessed with Xavi growing up. But I think you really see that, and it's the thing that differentiates him a little bit in the way that he plays the game from Barella, from a lot of the young Italian players. I think he's so much about the technicality, so much about the quick feet and little moments, like you see the Veronica against Cagliari, the roulette turn where he got the penalty. You think that's the hallmarks of his game.
Is it fair to say he's basically, you know, when people talk about like sort of a five-a-side players or like football de sala type players, I mean, that's kind of what he is, but he's managed to translate it to a bigger pitch. And what I think is especially impressive about Sassuolo was this was not a team, I mean, I don't know, I guess they signed him to have something different, but he didn't have a natural fit in that team. He sort of forced Zerbi to go and change the way they play to have that figure because, you know, Sassuolo was, you know, the diagonal ball for Berardi to run onto.
Yeah, absolutely. And I think what's fascinating to me right now with Sensi is that actually Sassuolo, again, we can draw a parallel with Barella because they both of this played in different roles, but most of the time he was a regista. Most of the time he was sitting deep and picking the passes. And already at Inter, he isn't that. Mm. He's very much being used to break the lines, to get forward, to get up and down the pitch. And to me, this looks much more natural for him. I think it's great to have him as the asset and do both, because it means that when someone does sit on Brozovic for Inter and close him out, you can go to a double regista. You can have someone else who can drop back and pick those passes.
And Barella can do that too.
Yeah.
But what do Italy need the most for the national team?
Well, I think the flexibility is the great asset. That's what I love. That's why I went for that midfield of Barella and Sensi, because I think that they give you such versatility as a pair.
What I'm not sure about him is just physically whether he has the stamina, because if you're going to play in that 4-3-3. Inter's a bit different because obviously they have a back three behind them. What I would be a bit concerned about is over the course of a season, does he have the stamina to run so much, get forward? Because that really is a pressing role, you know, primarily. That would be my concern. Might 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 we see him play used differently? Might he see him take over from the Bras and maybe somebody else comes in?
Yeah, I
mean, maybe Vecino to stand around and kick people.
There's definitely these questions. And I think the thing that, sorry, I didn't mean to cut you off, but just the thing that's interesting is he's already scored more goals with Inter than he did in any of those three seasons with Sassuolo. Right. Now, part of that is playing on a better team, but I think it really speaks to the different way he's being
and getting
used.
Those crosses for his tremendous headers.
Yeah.
Maybe we could start him sort of at the beginning of a match, further forward, and ask him to do the duality of the role, and then as the game progresses, just move him around. Obviously not. But
you
what is that tattoo?
You joke about the headers. He said, again, first interview at Inter, he was asked about where he could improve his game, and he did the studious young player thing and said everything, and he said, but actually, I'd like to get even better in the air. And he did win that header against Leeds.
Perfect timing.
Thanks so much for watching ESPN on YouTube. And for more sports highlights and analysis, be sure to download the ESPN app. And for premium content and live streaming, subscribe to ESPN+.